So this does seem to be a bit of an issue for a number of people. What if Russia launches their nuclear weapons? And the answer is really just stay at home. But before you just write that off and think, oh, that's ridiculous, let me explain why. There's really a very profound technical basis for that. Yeah, there really is. So let's walk through the process. Russia launches, we try to defend, most of their missiles get taken out, one or two make it in. Don't really quite know where, they're gonna make it in somewhere if they launch enough of them. So one or two come in. Let's say it hits Indianapolis. Well, it hits Indianapolis, but where is the wind blowing? How high was it and how big of a detonation? Was it 10 kilotons? Was it 100 kilotons? Was it 500 kilotons? How big was it and how high was it? That's going to determine where the wind blows. Now, the majority of people that die from a nuclear weapon event are going to be from the blast and the heat. And so there's really nothing you can do unless you actually knew the missiles were coming up and you were able to leave the city and get out of there within an hour. Probably not. The traffic would be blocked if enough people knew that there was a nuclear weapon coming in, and you really wouldn't be able to make it out. The traffic would be so bad. So those that actually make it, there's a small penumbra around the blast zone where you can get acute radiation syndrome. And there, the best thing to do really is just stay in your house so that you get the shielding from the house. You don't want to be outside. The car, the top of your car doesn't offer a lot of shielding, but the house will. And then on top of that, when we know how high it was and how big it was, we'll know where the wind is blowing. And so after that's been figured out, the nuclear emergency support teams from the Department of Energy will alert the governor of that state or the neighboring states and let them know where this is taking place. The governor then has to figure out where this plume is going and how to evacuate people along that path if it's not already too late. If it's not already too late, then you got to figure out where you need to be the evacuating people, how you need to get them there, and how the governor needs to deploy the state's resources to make sure people get out of the way. By the time all of this occurs, it's usually an hour into it or thereabouts. By the time they're able to figure out where the plume's going and what all the paths are that you need to take, the plume's already gone and there really isn't much dose that can be avoided by having people evacuate. And by making sure people don't evacuate early, you're preventing people from going and driving into the contamination zone and getting stuck in the contamination zone because of traffic. But if you stay home, most of it will just blow over. And as it's blowing over, it will dilute. So as long as you stay inside, you're shielded from the gamma radiation of the plume, and you're protecting yourself from being stuck in the contamination or the plume itself by not knowing where it's at. Because the authorities will know quite quickly, but they're going to have to try to figure out how to communicate that in a way that will minimize dose to the public. So the long answer is the same reply to this question. Just stay home and listen to the advice of the experts that will come from the radio or the television.